same theme, they give ball players nowadays very peculiar names. Funny names, nicknames. On the St. Louis team, we have who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
That's what I want to find out. I want you to tell me the fellas' names on the St. Louis team.
I'm telling you, who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
Do you know the fellas' names?
Yes.
Who's the fella playing first base?
Yes.
The fella playing first base.
Who?
The fella on first base.
Who?
The guy playing first base.
Who's on first?
What are you asking me for?
I'm not asking you, I'm telling you. Who's on first?
I'm asking you who's on first.
That's the man's name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
Okay. When you pay off the first baseman every month,
who
gets the money?
Every dollar of it. And why not? The man's entitled to it.
Who is?
Yes.
So who gets it?
Absolutely. Sometimes his wife comes down and collects it.
Whose wife?
Yes. After all, man earns it.
Who does?
Absolutely.
All I'm trying to find out is what's the fellow's name on first base?
What's on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
Okay. Does St. Louis have a good outfield?
Oh, absolutely.
The left fielder's name?
Why?
I don't know. I just thought I'd ask.
Well, I just thought I'd tell you.
Then tell me who's playing left field.
Who's playing first?
Stay out of the infield, the left fielder's name.
Why?
Because.
He's center field.
Wait a minute. Does this team have a pitcher?
Wouldn't this be a fine team without a pitcher?
What's his name?
Tomorrow.
Okay. I pick up the ball and I throw it. Me being a good catcher, I throw it to first base. Whoever it is picks up the ball and throws it to who?
Now that is the first thing you've actually said right.
I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Don't get excited. Take it easy.
I pick up the ball and I throw it to first base. Whoever it is picks up the ball and throws it to who? Who throws it to what? What throws it to, I don't know. I don't know, throws it to tomorrow. A triple play.
Yeah, it could be.
Another guy picks it up, and it's a long ball to center.
Because?
Why? I don't know. Man, I don't care.
What was that?
I said I don't care.
Oh, that's our shortstop. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the play of classes 6, 7, and 8. The Emperor's New Clothes. This is Bang.
And this is Bong.
We hope that
Wait!
You...
I have a joke.
Fine.
Okay. So, there's two guys. And they're in a crazy, insane asylum. And they're wanting to get out, obviously, because they don't like it there anymore. And so, they grab their flashlight and they walk up the stairs when it's nighttime. Up to the rooftop. And they're just inches away from freedom, just have to simply jump from one rooftop to the other. Not a big gap. And so the first guy jumps with no effort at all. But the second guy, you know, he kind of struggles because he's scared. So the first guy says, "Ooh, I know, I'll shine the flashlight across and you can walk on the beam."
"What, do you think I'm crazy? You'll just turn it off when I'm halfway." Okay. We hope that you enjoy the show. Also, if you're sitting in the front row, be careful of this wire going across. And now, the Emperor's New Clothes. A long time ago, or right now, or sometime in the future, the
Kingdom of Glum. Township of Glum. Located near the Ooze Tinkle Forest.
Welcome, welcome. I am Aaron the Minstrel, and I have a tale to tell you. Now, some of you may think this story is a bit far-fetched, but believe me, it's totally true. Pretty much. I mean, I should know, because I was there. Emperor Plumto was the ruler of the Kingdom of Glum. Now, in the beginning, the Emperor had been a fine governor. But lately, well, to put it plainly, he was letting everything go to pot. All he cared about were his personal things. His gold, his jewelry, his health, and most of all, his clothes. He was a clothes horse, a clothes demon, a clothes maniac. He had over 300 closets, all of them full of the latest and most hideous fashion known to man. Emperor Plumto, it's time for the public audience.
I don't want to. I'm busy. I feel rotten. I'm down in the dumps and I'm tired.
I've got it. I detect a little flutter of the crevulating cavity.
Oh.
Is that bad?
We don't know.
We'll find out.
It might be malohippoitis.
Malohippoitis?
Complete with the zigging of the consternation.
Zigging of the consternation. I mean, come on.
I knew it! I knew I had something horrible.
This is terrific. Well, don't just stand there flapping. Do something. Soothe me. Pamper me.
There is no cure for malohippoitis if it's got zigging.
No cure? I'm doomed.
Your Majesty, perhaps we could take your mind off this for a bit. We really do have a lot of business to attend and...
No! Nothing will help. I am doomed.
We must consult. Dr. Jones, Dr. Drift Tonsils.
Dr. Smith.
Tonsillitis.
Brain transplant. Cappuccino rarus.
Great. Right.
We have come to the conclusion
that you are suffering from
a rare case of
come on!
Cappuccino rarus.
Cappuccino rarus?
Oh my god!
Oh no!
It isn't fatal.
Really?
Really, but you must rest.
Take aspirin and drink plenty of liquids.
Oh, neato skeeto, does that mean I get to have cinnamon toast in bed and have weight on me hand and foot?
Of course.
Oh, thank you, doctors. You have made my day. Now go home.
Believe me, those doctors had to keep on their toes to keep him happy. But for all the money that he spent on medical quacks, he spent 100 times as much for the clothes on his back. As for the kind of clothes he bought, let's just say the Emperor's taste was all in his mouth.
Now go and hurry up about it! Cheer me up, minstrel.
It's time to meet with the townspeople. That will help.
That doesn't cheer me up. That's work. Cheer me up.
But, Your Highness, the people are waiting.
I don't care. Besides, I can't see anyone if I'm feeling badly. Oh, I'm not long for this world. I'm going, minstrel. Tell my wife I love her. I'm going.
Let's see.
I have too much stuff to eat.
I guess that'll work. Oh, Your Highness, I forgot to mention, the new shipment of clothes has arrived. Miss Trudy, bring in the new clothes!
Talk.
Sire, I...
Out with it!
The army are in for ship.
I've been elected to approach you about the funding.
Money? You need my money. Why should I give you any more?
Well, to begin with, our uniforms are falling apart.
You said it, Buster. Ouch! You little rat! Be careful.
So, what am I supposed to do about it?
We don't have enough money to buy new ones.
So, get some.
But...
Oh, my neck hurts. Jeremy!
Oh, my poor little snooky wook.
Ow! Stop it, Jeremy! You don't need new uniforms. In fact, I have been thinking about disbanding the entire army.
Your Majesty!
Have any wars lately?
No. The last year we used the army to fight piranha crops in the boat.
Ew!
I say, let them eat cake.
Huh?
Money refused.
But your goodness.
All done, all finished, all over. Scram.
Banana split.
I'm sorry, Miss Pookie, but I...
Don't you ever call me that again! I'm an Empress, got that, and so are my sisters!
Yeah!
Oh dear, my hair slightly mussed. Trudy!
I'm waiting, Minstrel!
I'm sorry, Empress, but my duty is to announce the...
Daddy!
I'm sorry, and I'd hate to admit it, but he's right. He has to announce the townspeople.
Daddy!
I'll get you all two banana splits after this is all over. Hurry it up, minstrel. Next!
Miss, or Superintendent of Schools, Miss Penelope Method.
School?
extra large box of chalk delivered to the castle. Oh, what colors? What colors?
What color?
Blue!
Blue, pink, yellow, all of them in rainbow.
Okay, all the colors in rainbow, please. Thank you.
Great. I have an idea. Jeremy!
Trudy's got a boyfriend, na 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 na.
It just makes me want to
kissy kissy black.
Jeremy and Trudy, yeah.
Jeremy
and Trudy, yeah.
Keep your mind on your work. You can be replaced, you know. Now, for my idea, let's turn all the schools into giant closets. Spare no expense. I want the best designers in the world to be there.
Whoopee, that cheers me up.
Yay!
Let's go eat.
No, Sire. There's one more waiting. Cordelia Glade Rival, representative from BARF.
BARF?
It stands for Better Actions Regarding Funding.
Jeremy!
Trudy! Oh dear, I have to
go.
Don't go.
But
it didn't used to be like this. We used to have time to relax and have fun. Now all we do is fetch and carry. What happened?
I don't know. When I first came here, working for the Empress is fun. Now she doesn't even listen to me.
Now she doesn't even let you talk. In the kingdom, it used to be a great place, but now everything has gone to pot.
Shh, don't let them hear you.
Trudy?
Yes?
I've been waiting to ask you.
Yes?
Would you? I mean, do you? I mean...
Yes?
Jeremy, you little twerp, hurry up!
Jeremy! Now!
Waited on and other stuff. He tried on his new clothes and ordered more and more, each outfit more outrageous than the last. Then one day, something very strange and unusual happened.
Okay. A kangaroo jumped higher than a skyscraper.
I don't know. Can a kangaroo jump higher than a skyscraper?
Of course it can, because I've never personally seen a skyscraper jump before.
Hey, did you hear about the kidnapping in the park?
No, what happened?
They woke him up. That one scared me for a second when I heard that. A few days later,
in town
square. Oh, this is it, Mr. Hogg. This is it. I have a feeling about this place.
Don't look all that good to me, Wart. Ain't much action.
But there will be, my good man. The populace will succumb to our remarkable talents. As they say in Elephant's Breath, Montana, there's a sucker born every minute.
I ain't never been to Elephant's Breath.
Suffice to say that once was enough. Now let's endeavor to set up shop.
I still say it looks pretty seedy to me.
Confound it, Mr. Hogg. You must have faith.
Yeah, it helps if you cheat, too.
Cheat? Cheat? No, we don't cheat. We fulfill men's dreams. We give them hope. We bring magic to their lives. Cheat? I should say not. We just bend the truth a little.
Yeah, well, I bent the truth up in that tree last night when nobody's looking, fixed her all up.
Good. Are you ready to commence?
I don't know about that, but we can start.
Fantastic! And I have another little scheme. I mean a project in mind. One that should increase our bank account 100-fold.
I ain't too quick at picking up new tricks, Wart.
This will not depend upon sleight of hand, but we'll rather utilize rather remarkable histrionic talents.
I ain't too good at history, either.
Not history, my fine friend, but acting, your acting talents.
Yeah? What I gotta do?
Oh, you'll see soon enough. There's an emperor in this place just reeking of money, and he's itching to spend it on just himself. I have just the thing for him, the perfect item.
Do I get a good part?
Yeah, a part that any actor would kill for. But now, the hour grows late. The throng approaches. Yeah. Attend to your post, to fame, to glory, to wealth, to work!
Starting that now, we've got tourism, we'll show you how.
If you got a pain in your rear, this fine tonic will get you in gear. If you're bald or you can't see, this here lotion will set you free.
No.
And might I ask how old you are?
I'll be dead on Sunday.
That's nice. Anyways, would you like to help me and lift these barbells? Barbells, ladies and gentlemen, that weigh hundreds of pounds. As you can see, though he tried valiantly, he was unable to lift those extremely heavy barbells. Well, ladies and gentlemen, all that can be changed. I have an elixir that... Hey, I do believe it's an opposing flame that eagle!
Mud puddle.
Right on.
Stop eating rotten fish cake sandwiches.
Girls! Shut up!
Go on, Mr. Wicked. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, inside of this ordinary bottle is an elixir that will change everything. If you are fat, you will be thin. If you are
ugly,
you will turn you into a ravishing beauty. And ladies and gentlemen, if you are weak, you will be strong, as strong as a bull. Sir, would you like to demonstrate the amazing powers of this elixir?
Yes.
Minstrel, call my tailors!
No, sire. We're the
only ones who have access to the magical tools that are required to make such a garment.
Do you know anything about fashion? I only have the best, you know.
Well, be assured, sire. We have studied with Calvin, Ralph, and Versace.
Really? Get to work at once!
And the Empress and the lovely Empressette. Shall I make some for them, too?
Dear, I think that only you should use the fabric. In fact, I think you should have it made into a special outfit for your birthday party.
Ooh, a birthday suit. I mean... And the Empressette, shall I make some for them, too?
Oh no, we wouldn't want to outshine Daddy.
It's Daddy's special day.
Yeah, he's special.
Besides, you already know what we're gonna wear.
Well, very well. We begin today. And now, who wants a bottle of our remarkable elixir? Job, so they all acted like there really was something there. As for me, I decided to keep my eyes open and keep quiet. Mr. Wart and Mr. Hogg enjoyed many things. They worked for 3 weeks on that imaginary suit of clothes, all that time asking for more and more money, which they got. They dined in the castle, received gifts of all kinds from the four daughters, and lay about napping most of the time. Of course, when anyone came along, they acted very busy.
Tell me, my friend, what is the difference between the booger and the broccoli?
I don't know. What is the difference between the booger and the broccoli?
Kids will not eat the broccoli.
We will now have intermission.
Food and driftwood with little succulent sand, pretty cool, I'll be selling over there. And a donation basket will be passed around for our 8th grade field trip to Japan.
With no teeth.
I don't know. What do you call a bear with no teeth?
A gummy bear. Oh.
I know that.
Hey, I wondered why the frisbee was getting bigger. Then it hit me. Welcome back from intermission. Thank you so much for all the donations, and we hope you liked the food. And now starting scene 3 of the Emperor's New Clothes.
This is the light. It will be a shame to move on. I'm beginning to like the amenities. As I see more of it.
Oh, somebody's coming. Back to the sweatshop, Mr. Hall.
Mr. Hogg, you should win an Academy Award for your performance. Ah, the good doctors, hail.
Good morning.
You excuse us if we continue to work? We're almost done.
Beautiful.
Exquisite. Such a sight to see.
Or not see. And how's the effort this morning?
Fine.
He has no use for us.
No aches or pains.
No crevillating cavities of any kind.
Well, for this, you should be happy.
We are not. Since you have come to Glump, the Emperor is healthy.
Well, maybe the birthday party will cheer you up.
Right.
Gentlemen, we are finished. I suppose we shouldn't be showing you these, but since you're so close to the Emperor, voila.
We can't believe our eyes.
And now, we shall store these away until the final moment.
Oh,
bonnet isn't done.
Finish.
Is it done? Is it complete?
I wanna see, please.
I wanna see too!
Me too!
Oh, Wardy, can't I look you lucky?
Get your hands off him!
Oh, Hodgy Moggy, Queasy Weezy!
Get your hands off him too!
My dear lovely ladies, let us not spoil the surprise.
Aww!
Mr. Hogg and I shall accompany the Emperor to the dressing room.
Or I'll give
you to him and these splendiferous robes. Oh, I almost forgot. We have a special surprise. Unbeknownst to you, we have fashion garments for the Emperor sets at no additional charge.
Really?
How sweet.
So if you'd like to don your new garments now, I shall ask your maid.
No. This is Daddy's day. Maybe tomorrow.
He's special. It's Daddy's birthday.
We wouldn't want to detract.
Are you sure? Then let's go!
Yeah.
saw this very thing. The emperor, your dresses, are waiting in your dressing room. Your maid will help you.
We don't need any help!
And I might add, at no additional charge.
Oh, how blessed we are. I won't forget this. Trudy, help the empresses into their new gowns. Damn it, strumpets. What are you doing? You're ruining my parade. You're messing up my new clothes.
But, Emperor, you don't have any clothes on.
Anyone who can, you are unfit for office. You are fired.
But you can't stand here in your underwear. Fired?
Anyone who cannot see this magical claw is clearly unfit for office. You are fired.
He's telling the truth. You don't have any clothes on.
Really? Anyone who would suggest that my husband would stand in the town square in his underpants is clearly unfit for her job. You're fired.
Fired?
Fired. I'm glad I found out in time. Anyone with any sense can see this beautiful set of clothes.
But I don't see any clothes.
I heard the clothes never lies.
How can an old man be unfit for office?
I don't see any clothes. I thought everybody else did.
Did anyone see me? I'm
a dead guy.
Here, Your Highness. No, snap out of this. Let's use this experience. Use it.
I can't use it. I can't even stand it. I'm the one who is unfit for office.
No, no.
Only a nobody would stand around in the middle of town square in his underpants.
Yeah, well, that's exactly what most emperors would do. But that doesn't mean you're unfit for office.
It does too. I mean, look at this town. It's falling apart, and I'm falling apart too.
This town really used to be something.
See, I can't do anything right. I messed that up.
You were a great emperor once, and you can be that way again.
Fat chance. Not with an idiot like me running the place.
Nonsense! You were a great emperor once, and you can be that way again.
I never want a new set of clothes again.
See, you're on the right track already.
I am?
Yeah.
Oh, isn't this just a holiday? What new wonders each day hold?
It isn't that you can't rule the kingdom. It's just that you let other things get in the way sometimes.
I've been selfish.
But don't you understand?
Understand what?
Now that you know it, you can do something about it.
I could try. I guess I really could.
We'd like you to try. We remember what you
can do.
We
can do it.
We can do it.
You know, dear, I rather like the old days.
You did? But I just wanted you to have the best of everything.
I know that, and I appreciate it. It was fun at first, but...
Oh, I messed that up, too.
Maybe it was for the best. Maybe it just reminded me.
Reminded you?
Of how it used to be. It was nice to be busy all the time and to help you with your job.
It was?
Mm-hmm. In fact, I get tired of doing nothing but trying on clothes and playing games.
I guess I could try to change. I really could. But I don't think the people would want me after all the stuff I did.
We want you to try.
Yeah, you can do it.
Let's hear it for the emperor.
Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray!
Oh, thank you.
Your Highness, I, Your Lowness, wish to say how splendiferous you look. I can see that the town is astounded as I am by appearance. But tell me, why have you draped yourself in that cape?
I was a bit chilly.
I wonder why.
yes. I shall begin a new cape from the material at once. That one is nothing for you.
I would be so pleased if you would do so.
The James is coming.
Yes, yes. Now the greatest surprise of all. Your lovely daughters, Snooky, Pooky, Coochie, and Yuki, wearing gowns of the most magical weave.
Why do you play the soul?
So if you sire. I must get back to Boren, Oregon, where my poor gray-haired mother waits beside her window with open arms and...
Enough!
Shall I throw them into the dungeon, Your Grace?
No, Nina. Sergeant Nina. I have a better idea in mind. Girls! I believe that I will turn these two scoundrels over to you. Does that make you happy? Well, girls?
I'm gonna dump sugar on you and let loose my ant collection.
I'm gonna pour cane syrup on you and let the woodpeckers come and peck on your heads.
I'm gonna make you eat boiled noose noose and okra pudding.
I'm gonna make you eat mongoose livers and lima bean stew.
Sire, I'd rather take the dungeon.
Don't you come near me.
Oh, let him go,
I demand to be thrown in the prison.
No, let him go, Nina. As insane as those four are, perhaps you should follow. Things will probably get out of hand.
Right.
There's three of them.
Well, I believe
there is one which is Snooky, two which is Oogie, two and a half which is Yugi, and three.
Snooky, Pooky,
no! Quite! No one wants to get on with this ordeal.
Together we can do just about anything.
But now I wish to excuse me. Now I would like to thank my trusted serving boy Jeremy for having the courage to speak up. I am promoting him to Amherst Advisor Number One. Restore the town of Glump to its original splendor, and we shall do it together!
And I wish to thank my serving girl, Trudy, for putting up with me, even though I acted quite unlike an empress. I'm promoting her to Empress Advisor Number One!
Anyway, and since it is my birthday, and I get a whooping big birthday wish, here it is.
Not again. I'm done.
I want the biggest, most fantabulous, most amazingest.